traditional proverbs that you could find. But I doubt you could find very many more Bible verses that offer comfort than these words. And I don't mean the comfort one. I mean this one. That the Lord's hand, well, Rebecca, her iniquity is pardoned, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. That's the comfort. That's the comfort, because when we are destitute and when we are seem to be alone, and even worse, when we seem to be attacked by the devil, you can't say that it's never happened. We have to remember, God created us for a purpose. Now that puts that on us. But God created us for a purpose, but this is the purpose. Redemption. Forgiveness. He created us out of His love to be loved and for us to love. It was a gift given unto us by God that we would have the ability to love. Anytime I do marriage counseling, I ask two questions. First question is, Adam or Eve was brought forth from the side of Adam. And in her sin, he didn't follow. Now that we are in the state of sin, you must be the leader. And when you have children, you must be the leader. For what was broken and fallen from Adam and Eve, it brought together here at this church. Bring the little ones unto us. The other question that I ask, or a statement that I say, is that if anyone had any reason to ever leave their spouse, it was Joseph. Because who would have bought the message, I'm pregnant, but I'm a virgin, and I'm betrothed. Who would have ever bought that? But the Lord provided. He provided an angel who came to him and said, in the womb of Mary is Christ the Lord. And in that womb is your forgiveness as well. Go to her. Care for her. Quite honest, I think that St. Joseph kind of gets the shaft because he was the protector of Christ at his infancy. But here again, we see this good gift that's been given unto us. Who is Christ the Lord? And what do we do? Tagline, I'm a Christian, has become a target for a word or words that mean absolutely nothing, like the word nice. It's said so often that it lost all meaning whatsoever. Are you a Christian? Yeah, I'm a Christian. When was the last time you received Christ? Yeah, you do. Yes, you do. And so what do we do with these great gifts and love that has been given unto us? We turn have noticed that in my own personal life, and I'm sure you have in your life as well.
The epitome of blame.
Eve said, or God said, we're told to eat of the fruit. It was the serpent who told me to eat of it.
Go to Adam. Adam says, it was the woman that you gave me. In other words, it's your fault. God, who created us out of love, it's your fault.
And can you imagine saying that to God? But we do. We do every single day. We think that we know better than God.
In this Advent season, we are called to repentance because we have made ourselves idols. And here, John the Baptist even begins to doubt and says, are you the one, or should we wait for another? Why, and I've always wanted to know this, why didn't Jesus run to John's aid the way that he did Lazarus? He even says that no one born of woman was greater than John the Baptist. And yet he didn't run to John when he was in prison. And John began to doubt. Send messages to Jesus. And ask him, is he the Messiah? Is he the one to come? And what does Christ do? He doesn't send back. Yeah. He points at his actions. Go tell John what you see. The blind see, the lame walk, the lepers are healed. All of these are not mere acts of themselves, because even those people died. The point is that it was pointing to the Messiah, Jesus the Christ, that he could do these things, that he could actually keep himself off the cross. But the fact that he didn't means everything. Are you the one, or should we wait for another? It is better that John the Baptist would die and that Christ would die than to go rescue him from prison and leave all of us in prison. In the prison of sin, death, and the devil. And there is the key. The cross. Shaped key that opens the gates of heaven to all who believe. So comfort, comfort, Augustana. Comfort, comfort, the people of God. Speak tenderly to each other and cry that our warfare will soon be ended. And this church militant will be over, and we shall all be in the church triumphant with the angels and the archangels and all the company of heaven. But until then, know this. You have received a double portion of the forgiveness of sins from Jesus Christ our Lord. Double. For all of your sins, Christ has forgiven you twice. That's something worth rejoicing over. Amen.